This region is full of endangered species. Their habitat is so fragmented and their diversity is being reduced daily. I grew up on a sawmill, so I'd seen my whole life the destruction of the environment and civilization here. To me, even in my heart, as a 5 or 10 year old, you could just know that it's not going to last forever. By creating hubs and small networks of forest in our region, we can connect habitat, and that will allow our endangered species to move through the landscape. We planted our first tree here New Year's Day 2016. Since then, we've now planted over 42,000 native trees across our region. The Miyawaki method can be implemented in any urban or rural situation. In the design, you can recreate a forest that would take normally 200 years in a bare patch of land. So with all the different strata of the floral species, small, medium and large, you can create a canopy much quicker. And as you'll see, the SUGi forests within 1 year are a functioning ecosystem. There's great biodiversity in the Miyawaki forests. The density impacts on the communication amongst the floral species. You've got 300 trees and shrubs and plants all growing at once together and interacting. It attracts birds, insects, and then that in turn creates a positive feedback loop. The life is attracted to the forest. I call it the Miyawaki Revolution solution. The southern cassowary, it's the only bird that will consume or have a dietary intake of particular tree species. We selected tree and plant species that specifically relate to their habitat, such as cassowary plum, the kwandong, which has quite large seeds, and no other bird is able to digest those seeds. We've planted those trees to attract cassowaries, and they'll be able to help proliferate that species of tree or plant. And that in turn creates more habitat, creates more nature over and over again. Here's the newest site. This is Dingo Pocket. And this is going to be the SUGi Miyawaki, Australia's largest and our 7th forest. And this forest will be 100 metres long, 4 metres wide, and will create a corridor for the fauna that's going to be attracted to this site once our SUGi forest is built. It's just really heartening to know that there was nothing here before. And now there's a bird sitting on that tree over there that wouldn't have been there if we hadn't have planted it. And that's why these forests that we've built with SUGi are so important. You know, they've proven the concept, they're field tested, they work. It really speaks for itself. What I'd say to the next generation is, if you want a better world, stop talking about it. Get out there and dig a hole and plant a tree. By the end of the decade, we'd have a fully functional network around the world. Piece of cake.